this prestigious celebration of the World Competition Day 2023. The World Competition Day 2023 is being celebrated under the theme Compete with Confidence, Consume with Assurance, Prospect of the Revised Competition and Consumer Protection Policy 2023. The event is happening at the same time with the launch of the revised competition and consumer protection policy. And the proposed theme is in line with the new policy recommendations. Today, we are here to recognize the power of competition. As we know, competition is not only about winning. It is also about pushing boundaries, breaking barriers, and striving for the best versions of ourselves. We would like to start our event, but before we proceed, we would like to recognize different participants in this room. We have different ministries, starting by the Ministry of Trade and Industry. We have different public institutions. We have different stakeholders, including the World Bank Group, and the European Union delegation in Rwanda. We have the Private Sector Federation, and also we have academia. Thank you for attending this event. Honorable Permanent Secretary, allow me to invite the World Bank Group, the World Bank Country Manager for Rwanda, to deliver his opening remarks. Thank you.
Good morning, PS, Ministry of Trade and Industry, representatives from government, development partners, private sector, ladies and gentlemen. I'm happy to be here to share some thoughts on the topic of the day. As the MC said, we are here at this event to recognize the power of competition. So enforcing effective competition and consumer protection policy is an indispensable part of the economic challenge facing sub-Saharan African countries. The basic purpose of competition and consumer laws and policies is to allow markets to work more efficiently for the benefit of consumers and to drive inclusive and sustainable economic growth. Vigorous economic growth, along with job creation, is necessary to eliminate extreme poverty and build shared prosperity. Globally, 600 million jobs must be created by 2027 to maintain employment rates, with 90% of these jobs being in the private sector. As Rwanda seeks to create 1.5 million jobs by 2024, we must create the economic conditions to allow the market to grow and private sector firms to flourish so that they can deploy the full measures of their job creation power. And conducive regulations are a key element to that. In Rwanda, most firms are small and informal and operate in low value-added sectors. Many lack appropriate inputs, technology, and finance. Effective competition in markets can support the smaller players and new enterprises, enable rapid private sector growth, and increase opportunities for job creation. This can be achieved through far-reaching reforms, including the elimination of restrictive regulations, better enforcement of rules against anti-competition practices, and improved competition neutrality. Strengthening the consumer protection framework can strengthen consumers' trust in the market and make them more willing to engage with other players beyond the better known household names that they already know and trust, especially in digital markets. This, in turn, opens opportunities for MSMEs to participate in the market and grow the market itself. Consequently, improved consumer awareness also helps consumers become more aware of the importance of sustainable consumption and protects them from emerging trends that fleece the most vulnerable. In this context, the importance of the new competition and consumer protection policy presented here today to achieve this vision cannot be overstated. An effective policy framework for promoting competition and protecting consumers can help accomplish several objectives. It facilitates entry to markets and encourages private sector investment. It ensures businesses interact on a level playing field and expand based on their efficiency and productivity. It discourages and penalizes anti-competitive behavior that closes markets and harms consumers. It also empowers consumers and strengthens their trust in the market. Additionally, it provides direction to enforce competition and consumer protection law more effectively, integrate critical principles in government regulations and policies, and more importantly, recognize the importance of allocating appropriate resources for operationalization. It supports the government's goal of private sector-led growth, including through ensuring competition on merits, on a level playing field, independent of ownership, size, and recognizes the evolving nature of markets, including digital and policy goals, sustainability, if you will. Further, it establishes a mechanism to safeguard and enhance consumer rights. Let me say a few things now on some of the work that we have been doing along with government. So I think the first point here that I would like to make is to reiterate the World Bank's commitment to support the government of Rwanda's efforts to advance this reform agenda. Last Friday, as some of you may know, a development policy operation entitled Boosting Green Finance, Investment and Trade was approved by our World Bank board for $125 million. In addition to supporting the CCP and the amendment of the competition law to strengthen market competition, and promote consumer welfare, this operation also aims to improve the business environment by assessing the role of the state-owned enterprises in the economy. Specifically, ongoing work to amend the privatization law will increase private sector participation and overall efficiency in the economy while reducing the fiscal burden of inefficient SOEs. Reducing the state footprint in markets to promote private sector-led growth that can take different forms beyond privatization requires complementary actions, such as implementing required macro policies and governance reforms to enable private sector investments. So we hope that the government of Rwanda, institutions operating in this space, RICA, Minicom, Minicofin, and others, continue to trust us as partners in pursuing a reform agenda to guarantee competitive and contestable markets where enterprises can enter and compete on a level playing field, and consumer welfare is enhanced. This will, in turn, boost private investment for economic transformation and ensure that Rwandans are connected and integrated into regional and global markets. Objectives which speak directly to Rwanda's growth strategy, Vision 2050, and National Strategy for Transformation. I wish to take this opportunity to thank the government, and specifically the minister, I know he's not here, for his guidance and leadership in championing effective competition and consumer protection in Rwanda, including supporting the development and publication of the CCP. I also wish to thank the Rwanda Inspectorate, Competition and Consumer Protection Authority, RICA, and recognize the collaboration for the preparation of the CCP and support for the amendment of relevant laws and regulations to facilitate enforcement. The task has just begun, and resources and capabilities will need to be deployed to implement successfully. So let me end by thanking all of you here present. Our continued joint efforts to boost competition and consumer protection will support the economic growth and development of Rwanda. I thank you.
Thank you so much. Let's appreciate again the country manager of the World Bank in Rwanda. Before we proceed, on your table, there is the agenda of today. But for those who don't have the agenda, we try to summarize how our day will look like. After the opening remarks of the country manager for Rwanda for the World Bank, we'll have the opening remarks for the representative of ambassador of European Union in Rwanda. After that, we'll have a keynote speech, which will be delivered by the permanent secretary of the Ministry of Trade in Rwanda. After that, we'll take a tea break of 15 minutes. Then we'll come back. After the tea break, we'll have a presentation of the key policy pillars, which will be delivered by the chief technical advisor at the Ministry of Trade and Industry. Then after the presentation, we'll have a time for discussant. And also, that's the time we'll have questions and comments. We'll have different people who deliver the comments. After that session, we'll have an awarding ceremony of the best essay writing on competition. Then after awarding the best student, we'll have a closing remarks that will be delivered by the permanent secretary from the Ministry of Trade and Industry. Honorable Permanent Secretary, allow me this time to invite the representative of Ambassador of European Union in Rwanda to deliver his remarks. Thank you.
Thank you. Good morning. I'm Michele Tomaselli. I'm the head of cooperation of the at European Union delegation here here in Rwanda. So honorable and representative of all the government here, the PS, Richard, the DG from RICA, the representative of the World Bank, good morning. It is indeed a real pleasure to be here today to this world competition date, but in particular for the launch of the new competition and consumer protection policy. The world competition day serves as a global reminder to all of us of the pivotal role that the competition plays in fostering innovation, economic development, and also in improving the life of citizens. Today we celebrate, as I said, not only the world competition, but in particular the policy, the new policy, the new competition and consumer protection policy that has been prepared with the support of our consultant that is here in the room from Arise Africa. We are proud, We are proud that the European Union, indeed, via this facility, the African Rise, provide input to the draft of the competition and consumer protection policy, and on the basis of comparative, that use the basis of comparative analysis with Zambia, Mauritania, Kenya, and also COMESA, East African Community, but also in the frame of the African Free Trade Agreement. The analysis shows that comparator regimes share similarity and differences in the structure and language of their law. Broadly speaking, these national regional laws cover all the traditional elements of competition law: restrictive agreement, abuse of dominance, and merge control, but with slightly variation between them. Moreover, different systems also recognize the importance of the strong implementation institution tied with the power to investigate violation and issue sanctions. This regime provides for judicial review of the decision of the competition authority, whether starting from a specialized competition tribunal or proceeding further to a regular court or just by a regular court. Africa Rise therefore recommend that the draft, we will see also afterward the explanation of our expert, but the recommendation are in particular linked to the fact that the drafter of the new competition law for Rwanda should consider the nuance in the different regimes analyze and only adopt elements that do not only meet the standard practice, but also meet the test of practicality. We are happy that the recommendation African Rise were taken into account, and we look forward indeed in the implementation after this launch of the policy, but in the real implementation of that. We thanks again Rika for the collaboration and the support provided by the team in Arise for the work that they done in Rwanda. In conclusion, I send my sincere appreciation to the organizer of today's event for hosting us and to hosting this significant event. So with all of this, I think I'm really curious to start the session and to hear more about the new policy. Thank you.
Thank you so much for a very good remarks. And apology, it was her remarks, not his remarks. Honorable Permanent Secretary, allow me to invite you to give us the keynote speech.
Thank you so much. For the interest of time, mine will be very brief. Let me extend two key apologies. One, Honorable Minister was supposed to be joining us, but due to similarly important event, he had to travel. So he attests to the importance of this event. Secondly, a slight delay to start. I think there was a bit of a traffic congestion on the entry. And I think most of the colleagues that joined came in a bit difficultly, but we started. Allow me, first of all, to recognize different representatives of institutions that are here. Country Director, World Bank, a representative of the EU delegation, Director General Rika, Director General RSB. I noted Permanent Secretary, Minister of Culture was here, but I probably stepped out. Heads of institutions that probably I'm not taking note of right away. Representatives of education institutions here participating, private sector partners that joined us to celebrate this day. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, happy competition day. Let's start from there. It is indeed my distinct pleasure and honor to be joining you and definitely welcome you to the celebration of the International Competition Day 2023. This auspicious occasion, as together as it helps us to celebrate the World Competition Day, is celebrated, and it is celebrated globally every year. But the importance of this is really to create awareness of the benefits of a healthy and competitive business environment. It also provides us a valuable opportunity to engage with various partners, particularly the private sector, to assess our market and identify any anti-competitive constraints that may hinder competition. This has significantly contributed to a positive business environment, has attracted also domestic and global investments, but also has pressed Rwanda in a business environment that is positive for all. Distinguished members, today, as we gather here to commemorate the World Competition Day, we also are delighted to be at the same time showcasing the newly developed competition and consumer protection policy that we, as mentioned by different partners, was recently endorsed by Cabinet. The endorsement and approval of that policy is an indication of Government of Rwanda's commitment to creating a fair competitive environment, but also guaranteeing safety to the consumers in the market. The new policy also testaments our interest to grow, to support, and improve the doing business environment for private sector. Later today, we shall be going through the pillars of the policy, and I don't want to dwell much on that, but I believe the design, the consultation, the support, the input that has been provided by different stakeholders from private sector, academia, and government institutions provides us a clear way to pursue the right way of indulging on global practices, both on competition and consumer protection. The policy has been carefully crafted, and it aligns with the national pillars and the interest to support, I don't want to always say a young institution, LICA, but supporting the mandate of LICA. But it also helps us to align with regional and global practices, ESC, COMESA, and CFTA competition protocol that was adopted in 2021. We are confident that this policy will create a level playing field for all market operators and safeguards the interests of consumers by modernizing the legal and institutional framework. Consumer protection is not a mandate, it's an obligation. And by us celebrating this day, we also play a role to it. Competition and fair competition is the best way to create a fair playing field for private sector to thrive. As we launch the Competition and the Consumer Protection Day policy, we proudly acknowledge the contribution of various policy and institution makers, particularly the World Bank, the EU delegation that supported the construction of this policy. We wish to express our sincere gratitude to all the stakeholders, as I mentioned, the World Bank and the EU delegation, but of course, the private sector that provided inputs in the course of the design of this policy. Let me once again thank the LICA, the management of LICA, and their partners for organizing this particular day. and our partners and stakeholders that joined us to celebrate this day on behalf of the Minister of Trade and Industry. Let me wish you a pleasant celebration and festive season. Happy competition, International Competition Day. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Honorable Permanent Secretary. Let's appreciate him. Before we go for tea break, we'd like to take a photo session. Our protocol will direct us to that place where we take a photo session. Then after the photo session, we'll take a tea break. The tea break will be served just behind this room. I'd like maybe we pass by this door to the photo session. And during the tea break, it will be a good time to connect and interact with different people. Thank you so much. The tea break was amazing. I would like to proceed with our agenda. Now we have the presentation. We are going to have a presentation of the key policy pillars. It will be delivered by Chief Technical Advisor to the Ministry of Trade and Industry, Mr. Alexi Kawaiza. Mr. Alex, it's your time.
Good morning, PS guest participant. Good morning. My presentation is going to be very brief because I know that it's not new for most of people who are here because it has passed through different consultations and sessions. And in addition to that, it is published from this date when it was approved by the cabinet, and it is available online. If you go on the Minicom website and you go for publication, you can access it. So I will just go through these points, just a summary and the key points in the policy. The first one, just there is a principles in the competition that most of us should be understanding why. The second, I will just tackle on the achievement of the old version that we were having that was there from 2010 and the key achievement for that previous. And again, rationale of this one that we are having. And again, I will go through to these key policies and I will come on the key policy actions and then the implementation matrix that I will not go for the details, but just highlighting the key stakeholders, institutions, and what to do. The first of all, competition principles. We know that if we talk about competition, we expect that there would no any barriers to enter or exit in any market. The issue related to the tariffs that can discriminate or be in favor of some of the players, absence of monopolism, those are the things that we keep in our minds. And again, you should believe that there would be equal opportunities, competition neutralities without disadvantages or advantaging some of the players. And also the last big part of the consumer protection, which is also most of the public are having any concern. And again, the state of play that we believe that the policy should be there. There is some consideration. First of all, we are not an isolated country. We are not an isolated market. We have to be in a framework at international level, specifically for the WTO. We know what does and what it requires for the state members, including our country. And again, at regional level, we know and we are aware about this IFCFTA competition protocol that was approved and is there. That also we think and we believe as a country that you have to be aligned with this trending and imaging initiatives on continental level. And again, it was proposed that at the IFCFTA level we should have this competition authority that also we think has to be aligned with us. Briefly, if I do a summary, 27% of African countries have at least these competition laws in the enforcement and the functioning of competition authorities. They are very few if you compare to the number of the African countries that we're having, 54 countries. But at least these are having in place. And again, 9 African countries have at least a competition law. If you see some are having even the competition policies and authorities, but the enforcement, it shows the status, only 9. And again, 19, they don't have no in this competition law and even any authorities dedicated to competition. There is a work to do. Then if we go down, Rwanda is also a member of the COMESA, is a member of the East African Community. And under the COMESA, 12 countries at least have these authorities dedicated to competition matters. At East Africa, 3 out of 7, they are having these authorities as well. And specifically for Rwanda, we are having at least the institution. I think that is the thing that we can be proud of, that we're having at least that institution. I want just to highlight from 2010, when we were having this competition and consumer policy, protection policy, from 2010, first of all, I want to recall that LICO was no longer there as an institution, and this was mainly under MISTIR as a unit under the MINICOM. That policy was having, among others, the objective of establishing at least a supportive in terms of the legal framework. And again, that policy, among others, was having the option of having options of the institutional framework, where at least we should have a dedicated department or directorate under the MINICOM in charge of this competition and consumer protection. And again, it had also to objective to remove these overlaps in the existing institutions that were there, and there were two at that time, RURA and BNR. That is some of just a few key that was in the previous policy as the target and objective. But now, if we go for the achievement, at least we have something that has been done. If now you think about the magnitude and the matters around the competition and the consumer protection, at least we have something that has been achieved. Competition and the consumer protection law, after just 2 years of having this policy, it has been developed and enforced. And again, the unit dedicated specifically for the competition and the consumer protection under MINICOM was there and shifted to RICA. At least when RICA was there, that department was shifted from MINICOM and being under the RICA. But still, we are having the shortage of the staff because on the structure, we expect to have at least 177 staff. One can say maybe it's a big number, but if you think competition and the consumer, it's not an office-based work, it's on the ground. So we can expect if now we go for instance, inspection for those who are aware how many staff that we need, and what coverage you have to cover, so one can think about that. But at least on structure under ICANN, that unit specifically for the competition and the consumer protection, there is 6. But as of now, as I speak, TG is here, maybe they are still having 4 staff. I mean, there is something also that has to be also considered for this current updated policy. And again, at least we managed to have a chapter under Lula law that is dealing with the competition. From the previous policy, this one is at least there. So now, after shifting to RICA, PSC has well said that we don't want to say that it's a young institution. It is there, but you want to support it to be big as big, as much as possible. Let me go for the rationale now, why we have taken this as priority for the ministry and as a country to have it updated. There is some of the key considerations beside the size of the institution, beside the size of the staff, the unit, the functions of today, but as a country, there is an environment that you have to consider that. First of all, we need to take it at a level to be aligned with the national and regional policies. There are ideas I mentioned at the Africa level, at the COMESA level, at the ES level. So we have to align it. And again, if you look at the market, emerging market that you had in 2010, and today, I'm sure even if I ask among of you, those who are participating, there is some issues that were not there, but today are still need in the way of regulating. You know, some what you call it, this multi-level marketing, pyramids. I think some of us, they are aware about that. There is emerging market trends that we need to tackle in terms of multi-level marketing. E-commerce, you know, it was not there. But after COVID, I think everyone here can express the experience. Green growth initiatives, we have digital mergers. All of these things were not captured in the previous version. But again, I have said that previously, not dedicated institutions, just having a component of it as the chapter in their law establishing those institutions. They were two, today we're counting more than that, including the other stakeholder institutions that are having some components or related matters about the competition and consumer protection. So that means we need to think about the possible overlaps between these institutions. The second, the other point is the harmonization of the regional and the continental framework. There's, for instance, a mandate under the COMESA Competition Commissions. There is the East African Competition Authorities that is there. We have IFCFTA. So we needed to align it if we have to operate in an open environment. And again, this policy was there up to 2020. That was the time frame for implementation. After 2020, it seems that we don't have that. Of course, if we talk about the policy, that means also the law has to be revised, as I said. So we believe that all of this was necessary to bring on board and say, this is the time we needed to have a new version of the competition and consumer protection policy. Briefly, I have to go through these pillars. There are five. In fact, the issue may be that it has been a little bit changing is the coverage of this competition and the consumer education information, and again, the enforcement mechanisms that now is requires to bring on board different institutions. But the other pillars were there, just we updated the policy actions and initiatives. The first one is to promote the competitive business environment. That is much needed. Second, we have to deal with the consumer protection. The other one, we think about those overlaps and the institutional framework. The others, the fourth one, this is consumer education and information so that we can fill the gap that was in the previous policy where consumers were not much engaged or participating in implementation of the previous policy. And again, to enforce the mechanisms. Let me go through the first one, pillar. I don't want to go for the all policy actions, but just to keep highlighting what is in the policy. And if you wish, you can go through in a full version of the policy. There is some of the key issues that we find if we have to think about the policy actions. One, under this policy, we have to address the issues, including risk of barriers to competition, as a result of the abuse of dominance, first mover advantage, control of essential facilities, as well as coordination among competitors. We have also to resolve the issue of the restrictive regulations and the absence of the rules. Where is it possible that weaken the competition and also misalignment? We have also to solve the issue of the absence of the anti-dumping and the safeguards in competition on the market. We think about the ineffective institutional collaboration mechanisms that are sometimes coming in all the debates whenever it is necessary and whenever there is a raised matters regarding the competition and business environment. We need also to think about the illegal mergers that are trending to come on the market and to be observed. So among of the poor sections, I just highlight this. We wanted to update first the current competition framework to address these gaps that I've said above and enhance its effectiveness and align with the regional policies. Then second, during this coming 10 years period, we want at least by end of this policy that we'll be having an established relevant registrations in line with the principles established to policy to ensure the competitive business environment. And again, we wish to have the update of relevant regulations and the guidelines to facilitate and the effective implementation of the law. The second pillar regarding the consumer protection, the issue was the existence of the effective and substandard products and services. All of us know, I think specifically for the institutions that are represented here, that sometimes and even the most of the times are involved in the joint inspection teams. We do that. I think even the market people, they know Minicom, they know RICA, they know RNP, they know RSB, they know FDA. This is a joint technical team that is supporting that unit I said that is still lacking to fill the gap in terms of the staffing, and we do some of the inspections. But among of what we see on the ground is this product. When you open, you know our country is open, the business is available. So, but if you find whatever on the market, we need something to regulate it. We observe, we find the things, but if we don't have this registration, this law, the enforcement, sometimes if there is something guiding you, the decision also is lacking. And the many repetitive the issues are on the ground. We have an unconscionable conduct and also a reluctant mindset to lodge complaints. If there is an issue from the side of the consumers, it's very quiet to find somewhere at least to handle those complaints. Even to know where to complain was an issue. So as the policy action, you wish first to raise awareness and set effective procedures to facilitate consumer complaints and the solutions. At least they can have it. There is good initiatives in terms of facilitating investment that most of you know, at least we have one stop center, but what is about the consumer protection and complaints? We need also to design and implement a strategy to consumer compliance with regulations that guarantee consumer safety and protection. We wish also to update the current consumer protection framework to tackle these increasing issues on the Rwandan market, but also to include sustainable consumer consumptions and the other unfair and deceptive market practices, such as the pyramid schemes that all of us we know has beaten in many times on the local market. We wish also to have established and reviewed relevant registrations to set a framework that is facilitating consumer protection. If I continue for the third pillar, which is regarding to this institution framework and institution arrangements that we have. The issue that was there, it is seen that still even though we are having those institutions, but supportive, this framework among the institutions is still lacking. And again, conflicting of the mandate we between Delica today and the other institutions that are having a component in their mandate regarding to competition and consumer protection. But this is because, of course, how this institution has been established and dedicated the mandates. It needs to be revised. And again, we can't ignore the capacity of the institutions that we're having. I have mentioned, Delica, what we're having. We think that it has been moved from the ministry as a policymaker institutions, but goes to implementation level in your institution. But still, if we think about the capacity of the staffing, if we think about the capacity of the capacity building for those staff, if we think about their capacity towards the work that they're expected from them, it is still seen that there is a way and a long road to go. But if we compare to other other countries on the continent, you see that at least the other countries that are having some staffing. So we wish also to comply and see that we can raise that capacity to perform this policy implementation. And again, the other issue is an formalized collaboration framework between competition authority and the sector regulators. That also, if we're asking today, I'm sure that even there is no any other forum that is bringing together all those institutions to sit and discuss on matters. This is needed. And again, of course, they are outdated of these legal instruments that we're having. Imagine if you have a law that is saying that you have to charge someone who is found doing malpractices, 5% of turnover, that was in 2010, and you think about the economic growth and the status of this current turnover, and you know, if you apply today, there is a still gap. Those who are playing with this, like RRA, or those who are enforcing like RICA, they know the challenge that we're having. We need to upgrade, to update also these legal instruments. Among of the policy actions, we wish to have this framework, institutional collaborations framework, to be established. We have a good experience, and you have a good lesson learned about the established one-stop center. What's about a framework mechanisms collaborating between these institutions? The fourth, we have to bring on board the role of all players on the market. That is competition and consumer education and information dissemination, at least so that people can be aware of that. There was a limited awareness and knowledge on competition principles and basic consumer rights for both sides. Be traders, consumers, the information is not flowing between those players. Some are having, if we are aware of the terminology that's being used, asymmetric information, practically is there. Inactive civil society, consumer rights protection, and organizations. Today, I think that there is some limitations of this civil society that was not involved much as needed in the previous period of implementing the old version of this policy. And again, we are lacking research around these issues, competition and consumer protection. If we can now, this coming 10 years, bring on board the institution that is having research in their mandate, at least they can inform the sector, can inform policymakers what to change in real time. So among the policy sections, I want to highlight some few that you wish at least by 2033, the end of the period of this current policy, that will be having an implemented and a designed competition awareness and education programs that is resolving the issue of the information that is lacking between the players. And again, information and education programs around consumer rights. And again, we want to bring board the role of civil societies. That is much important. When we talk about the consumer protection, sometimes they are the advocacy, the studies, the involvement on the ground by the another voice, different from the policymakers and implementers and the regulators institutions, it is much needed. I'm going to go for the last one in the enforcement mechanisms. The issue was the limited investigations. If there is an issue on the ground, who's taking what, when, and to report when, and also the the absence of these systems to help the receiving, at least receiving and responding to the complaints from the consumers or even among the competitors, some competitors. Again, the absence of a formal voluntary compliance program. Even if I was involved in malpractices, and tomorrow I take a decision to overcome, where is a system, a mechanism, a protective system that can allow at least me to come and express what I have been engaged in, at least to help solving that issue for the, in one way or another way. So among the policy actions, we wish to set up that regular capacity development program for regulatory authorities and personnel to appropriately conduct investigations and prosecutions of the cases. And this policy will look also how to grant adequate law tools to investigate at least. For those who are in charge, who can perform that, the capacity and in terms of the capacity that they need in terms of the tools and also in terms of the skills. And again, we want also to support our institutions that are involved in this competition consumer matters to have at least their capacity increased in terms of the human, financial, and the capital. Briefly, these are the pillars that are a main component of this policy that you can access. Then, if you allow me, I can just even highlight some of the other cross-cutting that this policy is trying to capture or to accommodate. The other thing is this green growth initiatives by encouraging business to engage environmental friendly businesses. Competition is one thing, but how they do cover these things that we are having also on the table and in our priorities as a country. And again, a policy does not left behind the cross-cutting issues in terms of gender, mainstreaming, equity, and social inclusion. And the policy also has also accommodate the way of handling the issue of the emerging practices on the market, including this multi-level marketing and e-commerce that we were not having in that period 2010. This big part, even though this policy is not having a big budget, this is an estimated budget. We believe if it is successfully implemented, even the budget can be that, or even more than that, it depends. But briefly, this policy is going to be implemented for the next 10 years, starting when it has been approved this year. And the key institutions that we are having involved in the implementation matrix that you can have on the table, they are the ones from the policy decision side, and also the policy implementer and overseeing its implementation as RICA, and the existing institutions that we are having, and we know they are having competition and consumer protection their mandate. This is the RURA and the NBR. The other institutions that we are having in cross-cutting, they are listed on the right side, including the RICB, FD, RDB, Rwanda Housing. But I wanted to emphasize this is the last one that was lacking from the previous period. This is PSF, civil society organizations. We want them to be fully engaged in these coming 10 years. I think the rest you can go through in the documents that is available online. And I ensure that during this implementation, we have established an M and E system that is going to cover the part that was lacking in terms of the evaluation. That means whoever listed there as institution is in one way or another, making sure that implementation is there and the mid-term evaluation and the final evaluation will be there. I thank you so much.
Thank you so much again, CTA. Let's appreciate again Dr. Alexi Kawaiza for a really good presentation. This policy basically is for everyone who is present here. I hope we'll be part of the implementation of this policy. We'd like to pass to the part of the questions and comments, and I would like to open the floor to everyone who feel like he has something to add about this presentation. But we'll start by the Director General of RICA. DG RICA, how does this policy align with the broader goals of the regulatory framework, both legal and institutional framework?
Thank you very much, MC, for the question. As CTA Minicom has presented, one of the five pillars in the policy involves enhancing the legal and institutional framework for consumer and competition. And the policy has recommendations. One is the centralization of the competition and consumer protection functions. We all know that currently these functions are spread among different institutions, different government institutions. We have RICA, we have RURA, we have BNR, etc. And the RICA serves as an overall coordinator of different programs aimed at promoting and protecting consumer interest. RURA also has the mandate to protect consumers under its sectors, its regulated sectors. And as well, BNR has the mandate to protect consumers of financial services. And this policy recommends that these efforts be consolidated into one strong organization, which can protect consumer interests and ensure fair competition in all sectors. However, this does not mean that RURA will stop its functions, and also it doesn't mean that BNR will stop its functions of being the central bank. The best practices elsewhere were also taken into consideration and proposed the institutional changes. Those changes are based on regional and international benchmarks. I recall one of the speakers has also explained that. However, this approach requires restructuring institutions. Therefore, the policy recommends starting with strengthening the existing institutions that have consumer protection mandate before transitioning the centralized system. Another policy recommendation is about the legal framework. In the past 12 years, several laws and regulations have been enacted to promote consumers and ensure fair competition in the market. However, this rapidly evolved market, it is really important to amend some of the existing laws, even to think about developing the new ones. The new regulatory framework reforms mainly focus on addressing emerging market issues such as e-commerce, which is really quickly evolving. And we also have new business models like multi-level marketing. And we have to promote sustainability of green growth initiatives to protect our environment. It is really important also to note that these have been regional and continental reforms. And the policy seeks to harmonize with these frameworks. I also would like to emphasize that this policy is for all institutions. It's not only for the Minister of Trade and the Industry. It is, you know that competition and consumer protection cross-cuts different government, private institutions, even civil society. So we all need to have some time to read through this policy and to see how we can really contribute to its implementation. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Dijirika, for highlighting how this policy will align with the broader goals of the regulatory framework. The next question I ask Mr. Albert Sol, the senior private sector. He's the senior private sector specialist at the World Bank. Mr. Albert, how does the policy help respond to the new global challenges, such as digitalization and sustainability, and also to domestic challenges such as enhancing private sector development?
Thank you. I'll tackle first the global challenges, digitization and sustainability, and maybe zoom in on the domestic one after. No? I'm not saying anything new when everybody knows that digitization and sustainability are or represent tectonic shifts in the way that markets operate. So it is no surprise that the CCP tackles these issues directly. No? But if we analyze these topics more separately, we think at the World Bank that digitization is a driving force of economic development and poverty alleviation, particularly in Africa. I remember 10 years ago when the Jobs and Economic Transformation framework was developed, digitization was the only cross-cutting initiative, because in the case of Africa, it can help stimulate entrepreneurship, youth employment, bypass perhaps deficiencies in infrastructure, and so on. All these reasons that we all know very well. But it can also generate some risks to competition and to consumers. For instance, in terms of competition, it can get to enshrine dominance, such as, for instance, the network effect. And to consumers, there are particular concerns that have to do with data privacy and security, for instance. So it's good to see that regulators and RICA are making sure that we are not using all frameworks for new challenges, and that consumers are eventually, and firms are protected. This is not an easy task, as digital markets, as we saw, can bear some risks. But I think it was said before in the presentation that a collaborative approach to allow stakeholders intervene when necessary is of utmost importance, no? And it's strategic. I think that in the case of Rwanda, specifically digitization, when we know that e-commerce is growing at 20% per year, and that the average transaction per user it's $150 a year, which is considerable. The CCP sets the stage for the modernization of Rwanda's e-commerce marketplace as well. And this for us is very important because, a landlocked country with a relatively small domestic market has to look beyond its borders, and in terms of services and digital or e-commerce, this will be also very very important. If the CCP, I think that bears all these elements in mind and is setting the stage for the promotion of fair competition, disclosure, payment protection, and bringing in international practices in all these efforts. So that's very important, and we applaud this fact. In terms of sustainability, the policy makes makes it a priority to support green investments. Countries around the world have started to include sustainability concerns in their competition assessments and agreements between suppliers, distributors, mergers, joint ventures, and all sort of sorts of competition instruments. This is particularly important in areas like the circular economy, in which there's a government interest in this country to develop. No, but perhaps the area in which the importance is even more clear is the priority of the government of Rwanda to stimulate green investments, not only from private sector but also public sector, in a context of a fiscally constrained scenario. Rwanda has made huge strides in its development trajectory over the last 20, 25 years, but it has been mainly led by public investment. So this shift to private sector-led growth is cross-cutting across all government authorities to make it a priority, and competition and the CCP that RICA and Minicom are presenting here today plays a pivotal role. So we see that that in both areas, digitization and sustainability, fostering competition is as important as protecting consumers as well. So in some countries, the competition policy and the consumer protection policy are separate. I think that it was a good idea to merge them here, because the topics are so much intertwined that we better have one discussion, no? And one rule. And the policy right now, and hopefully the law later, is very detailed. So as we saw before in the previous presentation, which I have to congratulate you, because it was very good. So just not to take too much time, the last question on how the CCP impacts private sector development domestically is also critical. As you know, this reform is part, or we have been able at the World Bank to support the government, because also we use the platform of the development policy operation that the country manager just referred to during his opening remarks. But we have another reform that is very much tied in with this, which is the privatization law that we have been working with Minecofin, and both I think that target the same goal, no? Which is leveling the playing field. And there's a lot to be done in terms of privatization, and of course the government will follow its own kind of like a pace. But according to our estimates, we made like an analysis on 76 state-owned enterprises in this country, and 70% were operating in competitive sectors. So there is room to crowd in further private sector in those sectors in which it's strategic to do so. No? In some other sectors, it may not. There may not be a critical mass of firms that can take the lead. So the SOEs have a very important role there. But I think that both should go hand in hand as much as possible. And I wanted to just finish by saying that, or echoing the words of the chief technical advisor, that implementation is, I'm going to stand up because I'm giving my back to everyone, that implementation is key. We see in different instances in the reform agenda that we have a very well-designed policy, for instance, in insolvency, and for years there was no uptake. So there's a huge need for institutional and also generic capabilities in the ecosystem and the other stakeholders. That's what we saw with insolvency, for instance. So I think not just the World Bank, but other donors represented here and in Rwanda are very much willing to help the government in this implementation stage, no, with this capability creation. So RICA will need also a lot of resources in place. We saw that comparison about the staff, and it was a little bit, but not just staff, no, also knowledge, and also a good plan to make sure that the capacities are elevated and that what we are presenting here today, it's effectively and impactfully implemented. No? So, but I think that this is a very important step, and you are setting the foundations for a strong framework and execution in the upcoming years. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Mr. Albert, for good comments, especially on how to respond to this policy, how to respond to global challenges. Thank you so much for the inputs. Now I'd like to pass the floor to Mr. Leonard. Leonard is a senior consultant at the Africa Rise European Union. Mr. Leonard, how does the new policy compare to international best practices in competition and consumer protection?
Okay, thank you. Thank you very much. I would like to start by saying that it's good to see the policy adopted finally. It's been a long process, and I want to commend everybody who has kept up the faith working on it until it got to this point of adoption and launch. Now, in the process of developing the policy and basically analyzing the framework for competition policy and law in Rwanda, which was part of the work that we did, we compared practices around the region, but also at the not just at the regional level, COMESA, EAC, and the new AFCFTA, but also the practices among the member states. So you have at least three well-developed competition regimes in COMESA. You have that of Kenya, you have that of Zambia, you have that of Mauritius. They have a good track record. So we looked at what the things they do. So in some of the areas where we suggested international best practices, which I see were adopted here, is one in the area of institutional framework. So it was our suggestion that the vogue, the tradition that seemed to prevail, is that most countries have competition and consumer protection merged under the same enforcement framework. You could multiply the examples from whether you're talking about Europe in the UK, to the US where you have the FTC, you're talking about Kenya, Zambia, Nigeria, but not South Africa, for example, in Africa. So yes, it complies broadly, and like the colleague from World Bank have said, because the linkage between these two policy areas is very strong. Not just the linkage, but also because of resource constraints for most developing countries, it makes sense to merge competition law and consumer protection. If you're a newcomer into the field and you're trying to build capacity, you're trying to create awareness, there's a tendency for people to confuse what competition policy or competition law and consumer protection law do. And in that mix of trying to find your way around the policymakers, around those that have the power of the budget and all that, you know, you lose momentum. I'll give you a critical example. I was actively involved in the process of enacting the competition law in Nigeria, and one of the earliest bills was rejected. Why it was rejected was because the lawmakers didn't understand why we wanted a competition law while we had a consumer protection law. Now, we took the hint, and we went back and merged the two laws into one, and proposing the disbandment of the Consumer Protection Council that was already in existence, and merging the responsibility into what now become what now we call the Federal Competition and Consumer Protection Commission. So it's a good idea. The only area where there's a bit of challenge in the case of Rwanda is where you have other mandates like quality inspection and all that within. So one of the reports we submitted did a thorough analysis and pointed out how that kind of arrangement could cause conflict, not just conflict, but also diminish the effectiveness of the authority. Also, in addressing the relationship between competition law and sector regulation, and I think that was a very important one, because if you don't address that carefully, you would have debilitating conflict that would make both the sector regulator and the competition authority not to be able to function effectively. Now, having a system of mandatory collaboration was all recommended, and we're happy to see that has been adopted. So I hope when the law is passed eventually, that would also be reflected in the law, which would require the competition regulator, the competition authority and the sector regulators to enter into an MOU to define a framework of cooperation. Now, one of the ways this could be achieved is by requiring the sector regulators. And I'll tell you something about the dynamics of competition and sector regulator relationship, is that in most cases, sector regulators are well-established, politically connected, and well-resourced. And most times, they've been in operation for many years before the competition authority comes in. And that has been the case in most developing countries, especially in Africa. Now, in this context, you realize that if the sector regulator does not yield ground, the competition authority will find it very difficult to find space to operate. Now, but how can you solve this? One of the ways you can solve this is that if you have the relationship enshrined in the law, but that's just one. But you need to also have strong political leadership that makes the sector regulators understand that they must cooperate with the competition authority. And having it in the policy is one of the ways to do that. And having it at the highest level, probably minister, prime minister, reiterate the importance of it is another way to ensure effective collaboration. So on these issues, institutional arrangement, you now have an appeal mechanism, which was not in existence under the former system. So there's an appeal mechanism, but that's ad hoc. I hope it translates to a proper administrative appeal mechanism. But also, the role of the courts are also important, because, of course, the cases will still go to the courts, even from the administrative appeal tribunals. It will still go to the courts for determination if people want to appeal further. So on these areas, institutional framework, in alignment of the mandate of RICA, in clear definition of the roles of sector regulators and the competition authority, and the linkage, the complementarity between competition law and consumer protection, I'll say the policy has scored a good mark in this area. So hopefully in enacting the law and defining the further regulations, and we've also developed some of the guidelines, for example, on market definition, abuse of dominance, restrictive practice, which RICA already has. In the process of considering and adopting those policies, we'll seek alignment with this policy, which should be the overarching guiding framework for the implementation. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Mr. Leonard, for very good input, especially on best international practices. I would like to pass the floor to Dr. Benjamin Rutimirwa. He is the Senior Manager of Research and Development at RURA. As we saw in the policy, RURA also will be part of the institutions that will implement this new policy. He has some input to add.
Thank you very much. And before I respond to some concerns and issues, allow me to thank everyone who has contributed to this document, which is very, very important and the key for our performance. Going through that document, It provides many things which will help everyone, not only rural, but every institution in the country. Because I hope everyone has to protect the consumers and has to contribute for the market, where we are benefiting from the product of the market. We are regretting many sectors in the country, including energy, telecommunication, transport, water and sanitation. And we have specific sector policies. But when you read those policies, some of them lack of details in implementation and the consumer protection. So we are very, very happy to have that document, which is one, cross-cutting. It's an overall document to cross-cut all sectors. And secondly, it provides many details regarding the performance of many institutions and the performance in efficiency of those activities. So for us, we can say it is a good time to have that document. Regarding the conflict between some institutions, I think many discussions aim to have MOU with RICA have already started. We are in discussion with them to sign an MOU, how we collaborate. And we have many MOUs with other institutions. And we don't think that will be some conflict, but it will be complementing the functions. So we are very, very happy to have that document, and we can promise that we will perform more our function and we'll collaborate with RICA. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Benjamin, Dr. Benjamin, for being part of this policy, and we appreciate that we'll be part of this policy, the implementation of this new policy. I'd like to pass the floor to Mr. Jelan Saiman from the Central Bank of Rwanda. He has some input to add.
Thank you very much. As you said, I'm Saiman Ajera, Director, Market Conduct Supervision and Consumer Protection at the Central Bank of Rwanda. I also appreciate this initiative of having the updated policy, and it will be so helpful to different sectors and stakeholders. So at the Central Bank, we regulate, as you know, different financial institutions, including banks, including microfinance institutions, insurance companies, pension funds, payment service providers, and so on and so forth. And we work closely with RICA in different perspectives to ensure that our consumers are protected. We also have a law specific to financial sector consumer protection that was enacted in 2021, supplemented by different regulations. So this policy will be so helpful in terms of our mandate. Probably, as Laura said, I don't think there will be too much overlap between the regulatory authorities, because to me, I see complementarity, as you said, by Laura, because we currently even work together, especially on the area of ensuring that we educate our consumers. So we work closely with RICA. And currently, we have to make sure that our consumers are educated. So we currently formed a forum that we call consumer ambassadors at the district level. So we are almost training ambassadors in all districts of Rwanda to ensure that they help us. Now, in as far as the financial sector is concerned, when I look at the competition, normally, there are restrictions in competition when we don't have probably many service providers. In our case, in every area, we have many service providers, be it in insurance, banking, and so on and so forth. Currently, we have more than 500 financial institutions. We also worked together to ensure that there are no entry and exit barriers in terms of consumers joining different financial institutions. For example, in our regulation, we say we have removed the cost for opening an account and also the cost for closing an account. Previously, if you wanted to close an account in a certain bank, you were charged like 60,000 Rwandan francs. This means banks were restricting you to move to other institutions. So these are the issues that we ensured that we addressed them in our existing regulatory framework. Again, in terms of transparency, because there cannot be competition when we don't have transparency in different products and services. So we worked with stakeholders to ensure that there is transparency, especially in pricing. Currently, financial institutions are required to publish their prices and the charges and interest rates at their websites and at their offices and the branches to ensure that the customer who is going to buy a product or a service already knows the price of that service. And if he or she is not satisfied, he can move to another financial institutions. We also established a platform that we call Jeranya. So Jeranya is a platform whereby it is accessed via website and a mobile app, whereby you go there and be able to compare different prices of different financial institutions, such that if you are not happy with your financial institution prices and charges, you can move to another financial institution. Again, in terms of the practices, so because the issue probably may not come from prices only, it may also come from the services themselves. We requested the financial institutions that you have to publish your service charter. Means, so what are the services are you providing? So what are the requirements? And what are the timelines to get those services? So that option gives consumers a wide range of choice to ensure that if they want a certain product, they can join this financial service provider. The other things that were problematic were like institutions probably sitting together and be able to agree on the price. Because when institutions sit together and agree on the price, you cannot have a choice. So that one is already restricted in our legal and regulatory framework. So to ensure that the prices are determined by the forces of supply and demand to the extent that no institution can sit together with another and agree on harmonizing like a certain price. So the other issue is that we've noted some cases in the past where some institutions can sit together and agree to stop offering a certain product to client or to a segment of clients. And that one, we worked on it, and we ensured that it is also restricted in our legal and regulatory framework. The other thing that you use it to observe is the lack of interoperability. Let me give an example for probably mobile money service providers. So you use it to have like Momo, which is not collaborating with the Airtel. If you have your money on Momo, you could not send it to Airtel. So that one was worked on to ensure that there is interoperability between service providers. The other thing that we worked on is the complaint handling as it was stipulated in the policy to ensure that if you have an issue with a financial service provider, at least you know and you are facilitated to lodge a complaint. So we've put in place an electronic platform whereby where you are, you can lodge a complaint. We have like a platform using SMS that is 6005. So if you are at home, you can lodge a complaint to your service provider and the central bank can monitor if you are responded or not. So you can also use WhatsApp or the website. And lastly, but not the least, we ensure that we work together with the other stakeholders, as I said, to ensure that our consumers are educated. Because one of the challenges to both competition and consumer protection is lack of knowledge from the side of consumers. If one institution is offering a certain product at the lowest cost. The other one is expensive, but you don't know. You will go to the expensive institution. So we ensure that we educate our consumers that to make them more knowledgeable about their rights, but also their obligations. In that case, we work with RICA, we work with the ADECOR and other association of financial institutions to educate them, the consumers through different platforms, including the media. So, but also, as I said, we ensure that we have a forum at district level to help our consumers get that knowledge. So, and we shall continue working together to ensure that this one is enhanced. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Gerard, for your comments. And RICA looks forward to collaborate with Central Bank of Rwanda to implement this new policy. As I said earlier, this is an interaction session. If there is anyone who have a comment or input you want to add on the presentation, kindly raise your hand so that we pass the mic to you. As you saw in the presentation, you have more than 10 institutions who will be part of this implementation of this new policy. So we believe those institutions have delegates who are here. So if they have something to add, we want to hear that will be part of this implementation of this new policy. So please feel free to add or to just comment on the presentation. And please, civil society, remember you are part of this new policy. You have to be among the implementers. So feel free to say something about this policy, because it can be, it's for also for the civil society. So you have to be part of this new policy. So we have a comment, or it can even be a question to there behind. Your name and your comment.
Thank you, moderator. I'm Dizé Damier. I'm the executive secretary of the Rwanda Consumers' Rights Protection Organization. Just is a comment and just to highlight on what consumers' organization in Rwanda is focused on. The competition and consumer protection law, I would like to thank our government for enacting this law, because we know that consumers association, we are there to advocate, and sometimes we are struggling on these issues on consumer rights protection. For now, we are lucky because we are working with the government, we are working with regulators, and also this year we already have a framework with the government. We have created a good framework because we have MOUs, different MOUs with Minister of Trade, with RICA, and for now we are working with National Bank of Rwanda, as he said. Mr. Gerard. For the competition and consumer protection, there is need a collaboration between public, private, and consumer partnership. Yes, we have this MOU. And when we see what he highlighted in the presentation, saying that civil society are not visible, how this can be enhanced in Rwanda, because if we see in other countries how civil society, like consumers organization, are working with the government, we have seen that because we visited Zimbabwe, Consumer Council of Zimbabwe, we have seen how they are working with regulators and the ministry. The ministry itself support consumers organization, even in financial. Regulators support consumers organization. I visited Morocco Consumers Association. It's the same. Zambia, it's the same. Globally, it's the same because we are working together. Even we have an African consumer dialogue where all consumers organizations in Africa are working together. For now, we would do, I would say that this is a startup because already we have this framework in Rwanda. And I think from this policy, we will implement together with public-private partnership. Regarding consumer protection, yes, some have been done, but we still have an issue of consumer education. What do you think as policymaker, as regulator? What do you think? Because already we have this policy, so what will be done in the future? Because one will say, oh, the policy is regarding RICA only. This policy have to be implemented by RICA. This policy have to be implemented by Minicom. So I think we have to work together. Not only the government, but the civil society also have to be included to enhance competition and consumer protection at the grassroots level. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Damir, for a very good comment. Your comment had like kind of question. Do you want to have an answer by now, or or who are you addressing the question to?
I'm addressing the question to the presenter of the from the Minister of Trade.
Thank you very much. I think the policy is expressing that holistically. The collaboration is there, and we can't achieve this implementation successfully if we don't engage your role. So in one or another way, you have said that the commitment is the collaboration during the implementation. I think that one is granted by the policy.
Thank you so much. Did you, Rika, had something to add?
I wanted to assure him that all stakeholders will be closely working together, so to ensure the implementation of this policy. If we can look at the pillar number 4, it says something related to consumer education. So we will all work together to ensure that this pillar is also implemented. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Digirika. Dami, I hope you are assured. Yes, I hope you read the fourth pillar. It's competition and consumer education and information. So basically, you see like you are included. We have another comment behind. Your name, your institution, and your comment.
Yeah, my name is Emmanuel Imanishimwe. I'm a member of ADECOR. Yeah, I have a very short question. Maybe it's a remark or what. It's about what the technical advisor, Dr. Kabaiza, said. He said that he talked about the removal of overlaps between the competition authorities and the specific sector regulators like RULA, BNR, and so forth. Now, my humble question was to know what are some of these overlaps, if it is not a secret. Now, the question being, how far have we reached in this process of removing them? Another intervention is about the five policy pillars. Now, I want to know the link between these five pillars and the four fundamental rights of the consumer. I want to talk about the safety, because the consumer has right to consume product which are safe, not substandard, things like that. And they also the rights to be informed, the right to choose, and the right to be heard. Now, what is the link between these five policy pillars and the four fundamental rights of the consumer? Thank you.
Thank you so much for your input and questions. CTA presented, so all the questions are being addressed to you. So I hope you will. You have the capability to answer all the questions.
Yes, thank you for the question. Specifically, what he is asking is covered under Pillar 2 regarding to enhancing the consumer protection. This is where issue is, and I believe that he's asking this question because if we go back and look into the assessment done for the implementation and achievement in the previous period from 2010 up to now, a big part and the gap was the side of the level of engaging the consumers and how they are protected. I have said even during my presentation that up to now, we are not a part of the central bank that is trying to initiate some of the initiatives to engage the consumers and to accommodate their complaints. But really, from 2010, consumers have been lacking in during the implementation. Competition, at least, but consumer protection was lacking. So in the Pillar 2, we wish that at least, first of all, whatever the actions, the policy actions that are there and the role of each institution is to engage consumers. But we want even, first of all, to establish this way of increasing the awareness of the consumers. First, they have to be aware. I was following this intervention from the central bank. Whatever they're having is quite, even we can say it's not enough, but it's quite significant in the financial sector. But even if we can ask ourselves, who was aware, who is trying even to complain about that? That means there is still a gap of the awareness and the bringing back on the board these consumers. And the second, the policies are targeting this the way to handle, to respond to the complaints. Receiving is one of the things, but to ensure the consumers are protected, satisfied for as the response they are getting from their complaints is the one that you want to look into in this next couple of 10 years. And again, the other thing is bringing a level of this kind of registration. There is a gap. Maybe I have not going through because we are not yet, we are still planning to have this deeper consultation of the legal framework as we are updating the law. But I believe even the consultation is going to be more deeper than even what we did for the policy. Because it's where we have to revisit the existing legal framework and also engage everyone to capture the gap. To know at least that we harmonize what we're having in existing laws, but also what we don't have at least is being captured and what was this being updated. I think when we're having a guiding legal tool, is helping everyone to keep the load. This is what I can maybe say from here.
Thank you so much, CTA. I would like to now to pass the floor to some of the students who participated into the student essay writing. They have comments or inputs. If it's a question, point to who you are addressing the question. Please, your name, your college or your university, and your comment.
Thank you. My name is Elizaphan Chiza from University of Rwanda. I have a comment and a recommendation about this competition day. So I would like to thank Rika and the other various institutions they collaborate with for the way they regulate businesses in a fair way through protecting consumer rights. A recommendation I have today is this. One of the most important way for regulating business and ensuring consumer rights is this. They have to promote mass communication to publics so that they can know their rights and educate them about the way they have to pass through while they want to handle, while they want to make a complaint. So there is also, they have to educate public about the way they have to start a business, because if there is no mass communication about public, so they can start up their businesses in an unfair way. Thank you.
Thank you so much for your input and your recommendations. I'd like to pass the floor to his colleague, your name, your institution, your university, and your comment.
Thank you. My name is Isere Valente. I am a student in the University of Rwanda. And I have a question. We saw that Rika have a few staffs, and I am asking, what are you planning to do on it? Because I think that that is the reason why the people out there in business, they don't know about competition policy. And this, that is my question. Thank you.
Thank you so much. DG Rika, can you assist on the question?
Thank you very much. Is it Valentin? Thank you for the question. We are really working on it. We are thinking of restructuring RICA so that we can accommodate requirements according to this this policy and the other laws we are implementing. So we also work with the young professionals to help them to be capacitated in different sectors we are having in Atrika. We want to keep increasing the knowledge of the young professionals to grow in this sector of competition and consumer protection and in other sectors. Thank you.
Thank you so much, DG Rika. That was a clear answer. We have another question from Benon. He's among the founder of Consumer Rights Club in different universities in Rwanda. The floor is yours.
Thank you very much. My name is Omnyanjis Benon. I'm the coordinator of University Students Consumer Protection Club, as I'm said. I want really to thank every institution here for this wonderful day. As I have heard from the previous speaker here, the main problem here is awareness, public awareness. As the club, we have created a club, University Student Club, to mobilize, to sensitize the public about their rights. And I really, really want to thank Rika, because we collaborated very, very much. I don't know if it is a question or a comment, but I want to request also the National Bank of Rwanda and Minicom to collaborate with us. they can look away how they can put some lessons in different syllabuses of the university, talking about consumer rights, if I can say it like that. But for sure, this is something which is really needed. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Mr. Benon. I hope the Honorable PS has noted that, and Mr. Gerard also has noted your comment. So if there is no other question, okay. I can see now the session is being more interactive. I like it.
Thank you so much. My name is Isabel Akwa, the Director for Center for Law and Innovation at CERTA Foundation. We're a legal foundation here in Rwanda. We run three programs. One is professional development. The other is our startup empowerment program. And we also have a research and knowledge team. So one of the things I wanted to ask in terms of civil society organizations supporting on research, this would be something we'd be very interested to do, especially with regards to competition law, the climate justice angle, and also the digital trade under AFTA. And so I guess the question is really to understand how for civil societies to get involved. The other question I had is the presenter mentioned a budget of 2.4 million. I was checking whether that's correct. That seemed quite a small budget. Rwandan franc 2.5 million, 2.4 million. If we could just get some comments on that as well. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much for your comment and your questions. Dr. Alex, those two questions are addressed to...
Sorry that I have had an internal discussion, but I think the issue is the budget of the policy. They said it's too low. Oh, okay. I get it. That is 2,410,000,000 Rwandan francs. Sorry.
So you had another question? About the research, how they will be involved.
Okay. Thank you so much. I have said that policies are there, but we can't wait for a mid-term evaluation or a final evaluation of the policy. We still need even ongoing research around the policy implementation. A policy is there, but it's not static in the way that we can't be informed as policymakers to see what to change in the course of the implementation. This is how we call the role of these institutions for the research around the competition that has been engaging these students from the academic institutions, but also in the middle of the course, wherever there is an opportunity. We know that we have some of the calls for supporting of the project. We know the one, the National for Science and the National Science and Technology, sometimes they're having. We know some other calls that we're having in the institutions, but academically, whatever they are doing, as the proposals, as the research proposals, that also can be a way of mobilizing resources to do or to conduct the research to inform policies and policymakers around the implementations in terms of the consumer protection, in terms of the competition. But we need that external eye in the form of taking a decision in due time. But that external eye is like another external assessment to inform us. So I emphasize that because there is a routine work that is being done by the policy institutions involved in the policy development that is formally as a mid-term evaluation and defined evaluation. But I just raise that because whatever the institutions that is having those researchers in their mandates, they can do it in any time during this couple of 10 years. Thank you.
Thank you so much, CTA. Leonard, you talked about the international practices. Maybe you can complement what CTA has said based on international practices.
Okay, there are several ways the civil society and research institutions can get involved, and I think CTA has enumerated some of them. So in one way, you could do independent proposals seeking for research fund to whether from local organizations or from international organizations. But I think a more effective way, especially for a new competition regime, would be for maybe Minicom or RICA to probably float a small research fund, maybe in collaboration with your partners like the World Bank with the EU, where you can then create effective research linkage between the local institutions and the more experienced institutions outside, you know, maybe from any other part of the world. Because by doing that, you then begin to generate local expertise, you begin to generate local intellectual support for the implementation of the law. So it's part of building the competition culture. And let me add to that, and I must say it's also in the policy, the element of capacity building. Let me say this, that you need to get the academic community engaged, and it's part of the research. So it will not be out of place for you to have a dedicated event on advancing research on competition and consumer protection. A dedicated event like this, invite the academic community from the law faculties, economic faculties, especially those two are critical, and then also invite the civil society organizations that are research-based so that you can come brainstorm, try to identify some issues for research, you know, and then try to see who can take up those issues for research. You provide little support for them to be able to do that. And alongside, as you're doing that, you're also providing them training. So for example, you can get the World Bank. I'm sure my friend from World Bank would be tired of me by now. You could get them to bring an economist, for example, to train, have a two-day training program for the economist on the economics of competition law, so that they can begin to understand how to analyze. So you bring your staff, you bring the civil society, you bring the academia together, and everybody begins to understand how these things work. You need it eventually for effective implementation. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Leonard. We take two last questions, then we proceed to the, I can see there are more questions. So try to resume your question, and if you have to, make it one.
Thank you. My name is Isaiah from Sina Gerard Entreprise Rwibutso. I would like to speak in my language so that I can emphasize on my question. Nuruka kuri Nyirangarama nitwa Isaiah. Ni ikigo gitunganya ibiribwa n'ibinyobwa bikomoka ku buhinzi n'ubworozi. Turashima igahunda aba police makers byo badufashije dukorana n'ibigo binyuranye RSB narika turakorana n'ibindi bigo turabashimira. Dufite ikibazo rero nifuzaga ko wenda mwadusubiza riba ari police makers ba Minicom cyangwa Serika mu byo dukora by'ibinyobwa n'ibiribwa mu rwego rwo kugira ngo turinde abakiriya bacu tugira ibijyango by'ubuziranenge ariko dufite ikibazo cya piratage. Piratage ni abantu bakora ibisa n'ibyo dukora. Murabibona muri Nyabugogo hariya muri gare, ngira ngo niho dufite ikibazo cyane ndetse no mu baturanyi Kampala. Ntabwo tubona uruhare cyangwa se imbaraga rika ishyiramo cyangwa se n'ibindi bigo bifite mu nshingano kugira ngo ibyo bicuruzwa bituje ubuziranenge bive ku isoko, kuko bituma tudacuruza uko twagacuruje ndetse n'umukiriya akaba yagira ikibazo nyuma yo kugira ibyo yafata. Ubu Kampala dufite n'abafunzwe bapirata Kabanga, twakoranye n'inzego zishoboka zo za Kampala ariko ntabwo tubona uruhare rwarika cyangwa se nibi n'abandi ba police makers kugira ngo cyo kintu gicike murakoze
urakoze cyane ku kibazo cyawe ni kibazo cyiza burya ibibazo rimwe na rimwe binakimukira ngaha hano hari inzego zitandukanye zihurira mu kurwanya byo witaga piratage arizo ministeri y'ubucuruzi n'inganda including RICA ndetse na Rwanda Standard Board ndasaba yego zitiye aragira icyo akivugaho
wenda n'izindi institution ziraza kumfasha ariko ikintu mbona kirimo gikomeye ni gap iri mu mategeko dufite na competition authority iri dedicated kuri ibyo ni nacyo nawe mvuga mpresenta ko kuba iyi unit kiri hasi cyane hasi mu rwego mwumva ibibazo dufite ku isoko we need really that a dedicated competition authority cyangwa se uburyo bwo kongerera capacity ihari kuri performing akore ibyo ntekereza yuko nindamuka ngeze kuri role y'amategeko cyangwa se itegeko rishobora kuba ryanakoreshwa muri ibyo nta nubwo ari common kuri nyirangarama gusa ibyo turabibona byinshi hari ibyo muzi tubona no muzindi value chains mu micere birahari kugufata ambaraje y'umuntu ugashyiramo product y'umuntu ariko iyo urebye itegeko dufite umunsi cyo rihanisha n'uwo muntu n'uwakubwira ngo urya applying hanyuma ukagenda ugasanga umuntu uri umuci 50,000 cyangwa 500 ku muntu ufite turnover ucuruza yo ngayo to be honest during inspection I think I can be quoted with some of my colleagues here in the joint technical team iyo namuhanye ayishyura ugihagaza ngo kugira kwereke that it is nothing kandi ntabwo waba police ihagaze kuri uwo muryango this is where we are saying police is there ariko igikurikiraho nabyo ni kongera kwa upgrading is legal framework dusanzwe dufite ku buryo ni nayo mpamvu nawe zivuga ngo consultations will go even more deeper than iyo twakoze kuri police iyi raduha guidelines y'icyo twakora pira 1 irabivuga ariko turukeneye na implementing supported legal tools it is strong enough kind of aligned with the national and international benchmarking and policies and legal framework dufite tugenderaho nahandi tukanareba icyo dushobora gukora nababwiye no rugendo ariko this is enough and a good starting tekereza ko tari kibazo kiri unique ahubwo wenda icyo nakabaye nitegura no gusubiza cyangwa se nabagenzanye basubize no kuvuga ngo when ibyo bishobora kuba bizagira aho bigera ariko ntekereza yuko it's a good that you are raising this issue at our knowledge natwe dusanzwe tuzi ko gihari ntekereza ko this is in the gap of the legal instruments that we are having zaba established 2012 zikeneye kuba updated ndetse na strong institution framework twaze tuvugana collaboration namwe mwese of course thank you
Thank you so much, CTA, for your comment on the question. Nkuko bivuze hari icyizere yuko mu byo competition policy izaza gukemura muri implementation zayo harimo no kugira ngo ibyo izo malpractices ziri mu bucuruzi nazo zihagarare. Reka okay, ngiye gufata ibibazo biri bya nyuma. I will try to take two last questions. Oh, okay, there's someone who want to compliment.
Murakoze kumpa ijambo nitwa Dr. Bayizi Marcel naje nturutse mu kigo gishinzwe ubugenzuzi bw'ibiribwa n'imiti mu Rwanda Rwanda Food and Drugs Authority nge ndashaka kunganira ntago mbaza nshaka kunganira CTA ibyo yaravuze birebana na updates za legal framework ndetse ni policy ko hari ibintu izagenda idufasha ariko si ibyo ngibyo gusa ubwo ndasubiza uyu okwasina Gerard ntago ari ibyo ngibyo gusa kuko ntekereza ko yavuze no kuri joint inspection ikunda kubaho kandi kenshi ngira ngo iyo twayifata nk'uburyo bw'igihe gito ariko hari ibindi biri gutegurwa ariko ikindi nasaba ndumva nshaka gusaba ntagaruriya okwasina Gerard gusa nabandi bakora business cyangwa se business operators namakuru nokuduha makuru uri yango ikintu cy'ambere namakuru iyo amakuru amenyekanye mu nzego reaction irihuta atari gutegereza ngo twebwe tuzagenda tujyeyo buriya no gufatanya kuko muri key stakeholders aba consumers business operators bose ni key stakeholders ntekereza ko amakuru atanzwe kandi kugihe yahabwa Minicom yahabwa Rika yahabwa Rwanda FDA n'izindi nzego zibishinzwe ntekereza ko ikibazo cyakemuka kandi kugihe turabizi turabibona ndetse ni byinshi n'inzego zigerageza gukora ibishoboka kugira ngo ibyo bibazo bikemuke ariko nubundi ntago hose twahagerera rimwe kandi abenshi murabazi n'abaturanyi murakorana mudutungiye agatoki ntekereza ko inzego zibishinzwe zabigeramo uruhare kandi ibibazo bikagenda bikemuka sinakubwira ngo byakemuka ubu ngubu ariko byashakirwa ingamba z'igihe gitoya mu gihe tutegereje za zindi zishobora gufata igihe kinini kugira ngo ikibazo gikemuke murakoze
arakoze cyane hari icyo twari twibagiye kuvugaho bashaka kongera kubijyanye na intellectual property mu byukuri byo buri kuvuga byo kwigana ni ikibazo gikomeye cyane kirebana na intellectual property ku ruhande rwa ministeri hari import bashaka kongeraho
ni icyo nibagiye kongeraho kugira ngo iyi nabwo ntabwo ari standalone policy cyangwa competition law nuko hari na nibindi bikorwa kuko nababwiye yuko iyatari ishu dusanzwe dufite yonyine hari nibindi bijyanye nabyo ariko nabyo biri related na intellectual no counterfeit eka nkore ikinyarwanda cyana ni muraza kunyihangana ariko kwigana ikintu cy'umuntu so murabizi ko nabyo ni we are custodian na intellectual property law and for information it has passed through the parliament nayo rero numva ko izadufasha kubera ko nayo irimo uburyo bwo kurengera umutungo kamere w'umuntu nabyo ntekereza ko amategeko ari kuna zajya avugana ari nabyo twaze tuvuga yuko we have a truck in both sides from the existing laws n'izindi zihari kugira ngo sikemure ikibazo iyo nayo ntewe twagiraga for information nibura iyo yindi competition rero tuzapudetinga ariko iyi IP law yugari n'ubwa mbere nta niyo twanagiraga numva rero there is a good efforts that we are making numva bizadufasha twese thank you
Yeah, let me say something just also to complement on what City has said, especially from a practical point of view. Ku bantu bacu bakora ibintu nkuko yabivuze binyuze muri intellectual property kwandikisha igicuruzwa cyawe kuri byandikisha kuri RDB ukagaragaza n'ikirango cyacu uko giteye ni ukuvuga ngo mwebwe banyiri kiriya kintu ni mwe mba mukizi neza cyane ko muziki y'umuntu yakwiganye agerageza kubisanisha nibye kuburyo ntabwo ari umuntu wari we wese uhita ubibona vuba ngo amenye ngo iki ni kiganano bityo rero n'abaregulator nkuko tuba tuhari yaba FDA RICA ndetse na RSB ikora certification nayo ikakora za market surveillance nuwa ngo banyiri ibyo bicuruzwa bamaze kubyandikisha na RDB nanone bakorana hafi no hafi n'abaregulator ndetse bakagira n'umwanya wo kukapacitatinga no kweducatinga abaregulator ubwo ndavuga hano mu Rwanda n'ahandi mu bindi bihugu mushobora kubyandikisha ibicuruzwa byanyu mwebwe banyirabyo mufite inshingano nanone yo kwigisha abantu bashinzwe kubigenzura kugira ngo bijye nanone biborohera kubitandukanya n'ibindi ibyo ngiyango n'izindi companies ziteye imbere cyane zijya zibikora zigatanga ubumenyi mwagiye mubona nkaho wenda tumenyereye wenda tufate nk'ipasi yitwa Philips ugasanga abandi batangiye kuyitira indi zina wenda pe bagakuramo imwe cyangwa bakongeraho indi cyangwa be bakazigira Philips ibintu nk'ibyo rero usanga banyiri brand bafatiya mbere kugira ngo bigishe abashinzwe kubikontrola yaba ku mupaka w'ubyinjira naho binyura kugira ngo noneho bashobore kubafasha kubirwanya kuko nyine urabyumva ni byigana nabo ari ibintu biri straightforward nubwo ngo hagomba kubamo niyo effort ni nkuko n'abagenzi banje bagiye babivuga kugira ngo tushobore kubirwanya ariko nkuko bavuze itegeko rihari naryo rizarushaho gutuma noneho bicika murakoze
Thank you so much for the comment. I will take the last comment so that we proceed to the awarding ceremony.
Murakoze nitwa Francine Niyigena ndi umukozi wa association y'abanyamakuru mu Rwanda. Abantu benshi bakomeje kuvuga ku kibazo cy'amakuru make abantu bafite ariko ntekereza ko abantu badashobora kumenya amakuru itangazamakuru ritabigizemo uruhare. Nibwira ko rero association yacu yaba partner mwiza muri ibi bintu, dufite abanyamakuru dushobora kubibwira nabo bakabigeza ku bandi. Tugira ikiganiro gihuza ibitangazamakuru birenga 12 en synergie, ku buryo gishobora kuba abantu bose bakurikira izo radio na televiziyo bakabikurikiranira rimwe bakamenya ayo makuru. So numva bizadufasha kugira ngo abadafite amakuru bayabone kandi mu buryo bunoze. Murakoze.
Urakoze cyane. Ngira ngo icyo ni ikintu gikomeye cyane kandi cyatekejwe muri police, kuko no kubatumira no kugira ngo mubanze mu involve mumenye ibigize police kugira ngo n'ubutaha muri implementation zayo muzabe muri bamwe mu babishyira mu bikorwa. Thank you so much. Honorable Permanent Secretary, we'd like to proceed with the awarding ceremony of the best student who participated into the student essay writing. I would like to introduce Dr. Pascal Nyirimana. He's a senior lecturer at the University of Rwanda. He's representing the Vice Chancellor of the University of Rwanda. He will highlight how this journey of introducing the essay writing has been. He has been part of the initiator, the pioneer of the student essay writing. As he comes forward, let's appreciate their work. This student essay started in 2019. He will be showing how the journey has been and just summarize how it has been an amazing journey. Thank you, you're welcome.
Thank you so much, MC. I'm giving you a title of managing director, sorry. He's the MC of the day. As he has just said, it's a long journey that we started for the last 4 years. Together with Emmanuel, who is the director of this department. And it was really enjoyable process of evolving the younger ones from different institutions around the country. I mean higher learning institutions, but to start with the biggest university. So I'm standing here, one representing the vice chancellor, who was not able to come today because of other important activities. But I'm delegated to be here on his behalf. Secondary is, again, informing the audience, starting from the senior officials present in this room, that has been a long, enjoyable journey of involving the younger ones, but also carrying out the public awareness on what is consumer protection. It's a new concept in developing countries. Consumers would be there, but they don't know their rights, maybe in different thematic areas of service industry. Mostly is where we don't understand actually the rights we are entitled to. So it's amazing day when we are celebrating our World Competition Day with our students, but also with our stakeholders like World Bank, Africalize, RICA, the organizing and the ministry, and all those participants involved from private sector. And I want to say Nyirangarama, Senior Gerard organization have been so supportive, including Volcano. I remember when we started this, preparing the event, these are the key stakeholders we met for the first time. They had to hear, understand, but also support. And I'm taking this opportunity to invite even more stakeholders to come on board. It's very important. Because when we have people from private sector being involved in this process, they will also touch very important agenda of protecting the consumers. And we make sure that somebody was talking of the intellectual property right in Africa, we are still lagging behind. And that's where people from the business sector, they don't attach a very big importance on the trademark, but also fighting for provision and copyright to make sure that they are protected along the process of doing businesses, but also making sure that they don't replicate other products that are not fit into our market. So let me take this opportunity and I would say I'm presenting 10 students present here from different learning institutions. The way we did this is actually involving many people, but also allowing them to participate and send a strong message on how they understand consumer protection. And the main intention is actually awareness. Though we don't have a specific curriculum, but we have started again now. I think somebody was advocating of having specific modules relevant to what we are talking. So the universities are sitting here listening, and maybe we can take it forward for academicians to craft a basic curriculum specifically that would transact this the consumer related protection and competition. So 10 would be awarded different award certificate, but also the best 5 are going to be given laptops. That is allowing them to access to technology and is doing research. Because I hear people are talking of research, why are we not doing research around consumer protection? But I know if you Google, you will never get empty. Some of research are there. Try to go and see. Maybe the Pure Rwandan, there are still a few, but I'm asking the World Bank representative at least to give us a grant. We are going to use it. It's a chance that we cannot misuse. Please open a grant, a call. We are there for it. And I would say, when we have students here, they are looking for internship. So legal firms present in the room, please give them internship. And the internship will be strictly focusing on the on this law instruments that can help them actually get more exposure, but also understanding the concept through hands-on. And therefore, I'm requesting the present institutions in the room to provide the internship in addition to what we are going to give, but also scholarship for further masters, going abroad, but also inside the country to continue, you know, building the capacities around consumer protection. And therefore, I would again request the MC, just to cut it short, to announce one by one. Can we start from certificate? Because they know themselves, those who are going to get laptops and certificate. So we can start with a certificate, and then we'll end up providing the laptops. But I'm sure those who will never get laptops, universities provide one. But also, in addition to that, you never know, they are big people in the room. Huh? You never know what you are going to get, isn't it? So how do we proceed?
Thank you so much, Dr. Pascal. Before we call students, would like to request partners. I will call one by one to come forward to help us by giving this award and certificate. Honorable Permanent Secretary, kindly you can come forward. As he comes forward, we can appreciate his presence. I'd like also to request DJ Rika to come forward. I'd also like to call the World Bank Group representative to come forward, Albert Sol. I'd also like to request the EU delegate to come forward. Maybe they stepped out. Let me request the representative from the Central Bank of Rwanda to come forward. I also call the representative from the RURA. Okay, stepped out too. I also, okay, he's present here. He'll be part of the. I'd like also to call, to request the MD of ADECOR, Mr. Damien, come forward, please. Also, I'd like to call the representative from of Sina General Entreprise Urwibutso to come forward. Uhagariye Sina General. I'd also like to request the representative of Volcano Express to come forward. Uhagariye Volcano Express na we as yatambo kimbere. Yego. Abahari nta kibazo bari budufashe. They will assist by awarding the best student. So we start by number 10. Number 10 is Bora Uzima Peter. Please come forward. Mr. Dami will assist by giving the certificate to Bora Uzima Peter. Let's appreciate as he come forward. Thank you so much, Bora Uzima. We need a picture of you with when they are awarding you the certificate. Look at the camera. Or the other way. Thank you so much. I would like to call number 9. It's a group of 3 students. Composed with Chiza Elizafan, please come forward. As they come forward, we give them some appreciation. I'd like to call number 8 is Kwitonda Jean-Baptiste. Come forward, please. Thank you so much. I would like to call Akeza Gabriela. Please come forward. Let's appreciate as you come forward. Thank you so much for your participation. I'd like to call Serse Rugira. He's number 6. Please come forward. Let's appreciate his participation. Let me call number 5, Vumiria Solange. He will be awarded a brand new laptop and a certificate. Thank you so much for your participation. I would like to call Mohire Modeste, is number 5. He's number 4, not 5, number 4. He's also going to be awarded a brand new laptop and a certificate. Thank you so much. I would like to call Musimbula Olivier. He's number 3. He's going to be also awarded a brand new laptop and a certificate. Thank you so much. I would like to call, what do I call, number 1 or number 2? Let me call number 2. So you will, of course, know the number 1. So number 2 is Belize Ndayisaba. Congratulations, Belize. He'll be awarded a brand new laptop and a certificate of appreciation. Thank you so much. We'd like to call number 1. Number 1 is Muganza Prosper. He's a student from the University of UR Busogo. Thank you so much. Before we go back to our seat, I would like to call all the students kindly come forward so that we take a memorable picture with... Kindly make sure your certificate are clear so that they be visible in the picture. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. You may go back to your seat. As we go to our seat, Muganza Prosper, you are the first winner. Please, of course, you have to say something. Just towards anything that you feel like you can say about winning this student essay competition writing.
Thank you very much. As the MC said, my name is Muganza Prosper, and it is an absolute honor to stand in front of all of you. And I thank really Rika for this great opportunity. Mine is just a quick one, and I'm saying that as youth, I have to be an ambassador, me with the other colleagues that we've been together in this journey of the competition. So not only this essay, but in any other aspect that we could participate to make sure that the competition policies are implemented, we as youth, we could be the ambassadors, and maybe anywhere that we can help, we hope the great names that are here, like we could collaborate with the youth, maybe through the universities, maybe through any other aspect or another way. That's really good. And mine is just like, I'm grateful for what I have achieved today. And I'm also happy for my dear colleagues that have participated in this competition. So thank you very much. Thank you all of the, thank you, Rika. Thank you to all the stakeholders of this competition policy. You are really doing a great work. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Proper, and congratulations again. He is a student in University of Rwanda, Kavem, Usongo campus. Let's appreciate him again. Now we are about to end our ceremony. Honorable Permanent Secretary, I would like to request that you give us a closing remark. Thank you so much. As he comes forward, let's appreciate his presence again.
Thank you so much, MC, and thank you for doing a good job. All protocols observed, Najirango Mbashimire, Mwanya Mwiza Tukwajize Hano, most especially the interactions that we have had on the last part of the session. Allow me to use Kinyarwanda for the interest of communication here. Hari very good interventions, numvishije zisa nkaho zujuje impamvu politike ya yihiganwa mu bucuruzi no kurinda abaguzi impamvu twayivuguruye. Biragaragara ko harimo byinshi twatekereje kandi bihura n'ibyifuzo bamwe mu banyeshuri ndetse n'ubucuruzi bwagiye bugaragaza. Sindi mu bijya ngo byose, ariko icyo nabizeza ni uko ivugururwa ry'iyi politike n'ubundi ryari rishingiye kugira ngo risubize zimwe mu icyo nakwita gaps cyangwa ibyuho byagaragaraga muri politike twari dufite ya mbere. So I can assure you the journey is just started. Hari byinshi tugomba gukora kandi tuzajya dusubiza tunaganira kuri some of the issues. Hari ikintu cyavuzweho kijyanye na piratage. Ngira ngo hari cases nyinshi tujya tubona za ziza ziturutse mu bucuruzi. Ngira niyo mpamvu twavuze ko hagomba kunozwa appeal mechanism ku buryo abantu izo cases ziba handled, yaba arbitration, yaba ubwumvikane, yaba n'amategeko aho tugomba guhana ababikoze bizakurikizwa. And definitely ngira ngo byanakomojweho hari izindi laws cyangwa andi mategeko yunganira politike y'ihiganwa mu bucuruzi no kurinda umugozi. Harimo ikijyanye na riri yategeko riri muri mu nteko rijyanye na intellectual property. So be assured ko we are moving towards the right terrain to really make sure that we respond to this new dimension. Secondly, hari umunyeshuri numvishije tayari yisabiye akazi uburyo bwo kugira ngo azakore muri rika. Nibyo ushobora kubona mu akazi wowe birangiza ubinoze vuba cyane akazi kazajya ku isoko. Ngira ngo ngadeje yabisubije turi muri we are in the process of institutional restructuring and it's going to be really given now enacting a policy by the government is one of the way to confirm that there is a need and so the institution should really be empowered to respond to that need. And so institutional restructuring is also coming within towards that. But thirdly also, we need to also have legal instruments that actually support the implementation of this policy. And these legal instruments, njango za jezi vugwaho, changwa amategeko, atandukanye yagiye avugwaho, we are going to have these legal instruments in place so that at least we respond to all these issues that you've mentioned over time. However, we cannot deny that, as earlier I mentioned, competition and consumer protection requires really a robust awareness and capacity building, not only to the institutions, but also to the consuming market. So there is a really a need, hari hakeneye ko twuba ku bushobozi atari ku rwego ariko n'abacuruzi ubwabo kugira ngo bamenye n'ubwo burenganzira bwabo. Ngira ngo mwabonye muri pillars zitandukanye bagaragaje hari aho capacity building na awareness zigomba gukorwa kugira ngo abantu bamenye uburenganzira bwabo ariko no kumenya why you should compete confidently but also why you should consume with assurance. I think that's the best way to put it. Because sometimes I am a consumer, but probably I take whatever I get and I don't have ways to complain. Or I feel like I just have to take it. I think there is a need for consumers to also be provided that empowerment
to really make their plea on some of the unwanted or unright products or services in the market. I appreciated the interventions provided. We are in two different sectors. We are products and services take us into different sectors, and I think that's where financial sector comes in. You might consume services of a particular financial institution because you don't know if there are others that exist that could give you the right choices. And so it is not you to look for, it is actually for all the players to share and present what they are offering in the market. And I think when you see institutions or companies making awareness or advertising their products, yes, it's a marketing way, but we also make it an obligation that at least the market is more informed and can make the right choices on what the offerings are in the market. So that enhancement, not only in services, but also in products, is required. And that's what fair competition means, but also the consumer assurance is all about. So I won't take much of the time. My last point is really to make sure that I give you the understanding that from the ministry perspective, with support of the implementing agency, which is LICA, and of course our development partner, by having a policy enacted, we are now going into the implementation phase, which now requires us to prioritize the priorities. I think you saw the policy is 10 years. But there are those gradual activities that we need to start agree on and say, our implementation plan is 3 years. These are the priorities that would give us a proper foundation to take off the policy in the right direction. And so we are going to probably have more discussions with civil society, academia, government institutions, and private sector to make sure that we are moving in the right direction. The policy is not a government policy, it's our policy. It's the only available framework that can enhance our collaboration. By having these broad lines and these broad policies, we should all of us see ourselves there. And I think that's where the call comes in. Civil society, yes, you appear in the policy. You appear in the pillars, and you have a role to play. Could it be on awareness for the consumers? That's going to be your role. And probably what we'll do is to collaborate with you to play a role there. So let us really welcome the policy with positive feeling. Let us be very optimistic about how it can address some of the divergences that we have had in the market. And definitely, our key players in the implementation of this, be it BNR, be it RULA, be it RICA, RSB, RFDA, these are key institutions that we think, if they are also coherently strengthened, or their working arrangement is strengthened, it will help us to really take it further from here. So we really further ado, I really want to thank very positive contribution that have been provided in the course of this discussion. It was competition and consumer protection, competition international day celebration, but I think it was also an opportunity for us to have a reflection on why we are bringing a new policy in the space and what you should expect, but also redefine properly what your different roles are as we go forward. So I really thank our partners, RICA Management, for your organizing this event, World Bank, EU contributing to the process, of course, private sector and civil society and academia. I also want to congratulate the students that have been awarded today. I think one of the ways that we can sustain the spirit of competition and consumer protection is to instill it in our young people. And I think if it starts from schools, I like the idea of developing programs in education institutions. This is the only way we can make sure that we are instilling these practices, not enforcing them. Because enforcement should not be the first. It should actually be instilled within our education institutions. It should be instilled in the young people that are doing these papers. So by awarding you, We are not only awarding you, but we are saying, please take it forward and keep this with you as you go through your academic processes. So thank you so much, everyone, for honoring the occasion. And for those who celebrate the festive season, once again, I say Merry Christmas and Happy New Year. Thank you.
Let's appreciate again, Honorable Permanent Secretary. Honorable Permanent Secretary, thank you so much for the closing remarks, and we really appreciate your presence here today. Also, I'd like to thank everyone who is present here today, both physically and virtually. For those who doesn't know, this event is being live streamed on YouTube. The channel is Inspectorate Rwanda. It's the YouTube channel of RICA. So I recommend students after this event, you go back and you see how the event was. Thank you for being part of this celebration of the World Competition Day 2023. I would like to conclude by saying that may the spirit of health competition continue to ignite our passions, drive innovation, and unite us in our shared quest for excellence. As we step out, we have been given coupon for lunch. You can see two ladies standing there. So we'll follow them to the lunch place. So please make sure you follow those black colors. So thank you so much. I would like to end by wishing you a happy World Competition Day and enjoy your lunch. Thank you so much.